Welcome friends to my channel Trading Sensation. I hope you all are doing good. Yes friends, Nifty is at all time high and people are really confused that what is going to happen next, because everyone is in a very euphoric state, you can say, correct? I previously mentioned about few levels. If you are a regular follower, then you should know it. That is, I had mentioned this level of 16 to 23. And you know, last week, you can see the close, open high, low close from this top left hand side. So last week close was 16 to 38 and my level was 16 to 23. Clear? So we have reached the first target, and above that I mentioned 16,650, then 17,000, then 17,500. Clear? Now let us get into the smaller time frame, that is, let us see in hourly chart, the hourly periodicity. Clear? Let me just adjust the chart so that it becomes visually clear to you. You can see that the importance of this 16,223. This is on 4th August. You can see that the candle, this green candle, opened with a gap up and then it just breached this level. And after that, you just see the following candles. Let me just zoom in more so that you can see. So once this level got breached, you can see that consecutively for the next 3 days, I mean, after this particular candle breached, so many candles in hourly time frame, you can see it never gave a closing below 16,223. So by this, you can definitely understand the importance of this zone or level. Clear? Now, remember few things, that till this level is hold or respected, expect Nifty to surge higher. It will retest the high again, that is 16,350 zone. And as of now, this 16,350 and 16,220 is the band in Nifty spot. So once either of these two levels get breached, you won't see any kind of movement. You will see a consolidation. And once this level is breached, then again, I have mentioned you that on the upside, the next target should be around 16,650, correct? And on the downside, you should see few levels minutely, because there was a gap up. Let me just draw a line here. So if I just draw a line from this low, of this particular candle, you can see that the low is 16,176. So below 16,223, the high or the ceiling of this particular gap. So where is the gap? This is the gap. So the gap is 16,146 to 16,176. So a 30 points gap is there. And you know that gap always acts as a very important or crucial levels or zones, you can say. So over here in this present scenario, it would definitely act as a very important support. Clear? So the high or the ceiling of this particular gap is 16,176. So below 16,223, 16,176 should be the first or immediate support that Nifty would get. And after that, the floor of this particular gap, that is 16,146, this level would provide support to Nifty. So this 30 points is a very, very important zone for Nifty as of now. So once 16,146 gets breached, then the next, obviously, the important psychological level would be around this 16,000 zone. Clear? And once 16,000 zone gets breached, then expect Nifty to come down towards this 15,950, which is again a very, very important crucial level, this particular zone, that is the previous high. Clear? So please mark the levels at your end, because on the higher side you should remember 16,350 and on the downside 16,220. This is the band for Nifty. So once this band of 16,350 or 16,220 gets breached, then the momentum, the next momentum will get initiated. Clear? Now let us look for Bank Nifty. So again in Bank Nifty, I'll explain the spot chart. I'll straight away go to monthly chart at first, because I have to show you a very important level, or you can say a secular trend line, which is very, very important. This is multi-year, you can say it's a more than a decade trend line. So I have started or initiated this trend line from December 2007. Now you can see this blue colored upward sloping dotted line, it went up, and presently in the present instances, that means for the last few months, that is almost 6 months counting the present one, you can see that it is unable to cross this blue colored line. So this particular zone is very, very important for Bank Nifty. Let us delve deeper and see the hourly or daily chart. Let us go to daily chart. So again on the daily chart, you can see that here from this May 21, you can see that so many times it tried to breach this line on the higher side, but it failed. It failed badly and it came down to around 34,200 level. Clear? So again, in the last day, you can see that Bank Nifty again gave a closing just below this level of blue dotted line. So until and unless this level gets breached, Bank Nifty should hover around this zone of 36,000 to 35,000. And below that, I have marked the levels, that is 34,240 and 33,940. And above 36,000, you should expect this particular level as the next hurdle, that is 36,500. And above that, it should be all-time high around 37,620. So that is far away from here. Consider the importance of this blue dotted line, because it will play a major pivotal role from here. Clear? Now let us see gold chart. In the meantime, I would request you all, please join my Telegram channel. The link is given in the description box. It's free of cost, you don't require anything. So this is the daily chart of COMEX gold. I'm showing you the COMEX gold, so you can easily play it in MCX gold if you want. So I have drawn again a very important trend line. This is multi-year trend line. You can see this is from May 2019. I have drawn this line. So once, twice over here, and then thrice, this is the fourth time. Then again, last candle, you can see the daily close, or you can say the low is around 1759 and the close is 1763. So this is at a very, very important level right now. So if this level or the low gets breached, especially 1750 gets breached, then expect gold to come towards this level of 1670. Clear? So I am little bearish in gold from here. So you can obviously go for short in gold. Clear? Now I'll explain silver. This is again the silver for COMEX. You can easily correlate it with the MCX silver. So again, these are some of the major pivotal level in this silver. You can see that 26 on the higher side, on the lower side it's 24.715, and then again it's 21.6, which are very, very important level. And now the major thing that has happened on last trading session, you can see it breached this 24.715 after this particular day, that is from 6th or 5th of April. It never breached this level, correct? So again in silver, आई एम अगेन बेयरिश लाइक गोल्ड, बट वन थिंग यू शुड रिमेंबर दैट इफ इट फॉल्स देर इज अ वेरी हाई probability for both gold and silver to fall, but gold will be more bearish compared to silver. That means silver will fall less compared to gold. Clear? So expect both these precious metals to come down in the coming week. Now let us focus on two stocks I would like to share, that is Siemens India. So Siemens is at a very important level, you can see, not very bullish, but kind of looking good, you can say. So it is hovering around this 2100 level right now. The close is, you can see, it's 2085. So above this 2100, expect it to go towards this 2150, and above that it's 2170 or 80. So I am not giving a very high target. So I am expecting it to surge little higher from here. Clear? Now then again, Manali Petro, I would like to share the chart of Manali Petro. So Manali Petro, again I would like to draw a line here, a trend line. I really believe a lot in trend lines because it works wonders for me. So I am trying to draw it from here. Just watch it minutely. So in the last trading session, you can see that Manali Petro gave a closing above this trend line. Basically, it's a breakout, correct? So we still don't know that whether it's a true breakout or a false breakout. So this level of 94.95 is very important as of now. Why? Because this is the breakout level, correct? So if this is a true breakout, then that level will get tested and again price will go from here on the higher side. And if this is a fake breakout, then expect price to come down. So mark this level 94.95. Overall, on higher time frame, this chart is looking good. So I'm expecting it to go higher in the coming days as well. So this is all for today's session. I hope you liked it. Please don't forget to put a comment in the comment section. And please give a like and share it with your near and dear ones. Have a great trading session tomorrow. Goodbye.